Hello, my loves. Guys, I'm sorry this is coming out just a little bit late. I'm having some real issues getting my life together. I don't know what to tell you. I'm just being honest, okay? All right, guys. So, this is going to be for Aries Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. Guys, we're going to do a quick shuffle here on camera. We're going to go over some super quick announcements, get into your pre-shuffle message, and then we are going to get into the reading, okay? So let's get started. Holy Spirit, angel spirits, and guides, what messages do we have for my Aries today, please, Spirit? What clarity and guidance can we get for my Aries today, please? Holy Spirit, angel spirits, and guides, what messages do we have today for my Aries? What do my Aries need to hear today? I keep saying need to hear today regarding love, please, Holy Spirit. Okay, Aries. So, guys, if you're currently subscribed, welcome back. And if you have not yet subscribed, please be sure to click that red subscribe button on the bottom right-hand corner underneath this video. I do choose multiple subscribers every month for free readings. I give away tarot cards, oracle cards, and I'm actually thinking about starting doing jewelry, too. Maybe some chakra bracelets or something like that. The winners are announced on the first of every month, guys. So if you're currently a subscriber and you have not seen that video for the winners, it'll be listed in the description box below, okay? So check it out to see if you've won anything. You can book a personal reading with me through my website, www.thetarotoflight.com. It is also listed in the description box below. I do have over 100 tarot decks and oracle decks. I can't stop shopping. So, if you are interested in purchasing tarot, or if you like any of the decks that you see here, you can go to my website. There are links to purchase, okay? Today, we're going to be using the Shadowscape Tarot. We're using the Romance Angel Oracle, the Quantum Oracle, and the Energy Oracle, okay? So, let's go ahead. Oh, and I'm so sorry. I wanted to give a special shout out to Care and Healing Channel. It's a for tarot reading. I ran across the channel the other day. Really good channel. You guys should check it out. Care and Healing Channel. Okay, just trying to spread the love, guys. So let's go ahead and get into your pre-shuffle message. So Aries, aw. I just wanted to like hug you guys. Like, so this could be your energy. This could be your person's energy. Someone's energy in or around you, okay? But someone here is dealing with a lot of emotional confliction inside, okay? What I'm feeling here is that you were hoping to hear from somebody. You were hoping that there would be conversation, communication, to get a text message. You were just hoping to hear from somebody. And as the days go by, you know, one after the other, you know, Monday goes by, nothing. Tuesday goes by, nothing. You know, Wednesday goes by, still nothing. You're starting to really understand that, you know, maybe you were telling yourself excuses. Okay, they're being held up right now, or they're working a lot, or, you know, whatever the case may be. Maybe they just forgot today. Maybe they're just not feeling well or whatever, you know. But as the days go on, more and more that you're not hearing from this person, you're starting to realize that this is like a conscious decision that they don't want to communicate with you, that they don't, that they're just not reaching out. They're not coming in with an apology, an offer. They're just not like, hey, you want to get some coffee? Like nothing. You know what I'm saying? They're actually making the decision to not talk to you. And you're starting to miss communication from this person. You're starting to think about them, miss them, the fun times that you had, whatever the case may be. Like, wow, is this really over that now I'm not hearing from this person at all anymore? You know, you may get thoughts in your mind like, wow, have they really moved on to someone new, or have they found, now this could be a friend, a family member, whatever the case may be, you know what I'm saying? This could even be something as simple as, you know, you're a child and you're used to your parent being single and always being with you, and now they're dating someone else and you're not really hearing from them every day anymore. You know, you're just, this is someone who you were around all the time. You thought things were great. You thought things were fine. And now you're just not hearing from them anymore. And I do feel that for quite some time, you guys kind of made like an excuse, like, all right, then maybe they're busy, or maybe they got sick, or maybe they're not feeling well, and you're just not hearing from them. And now under the deck, we have the Queen of Pentacles, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy. So I feel that, you know, now you're kind of, like, sitting here, like, wow, did they really just kind of walk away from me and just, like, ghost me to go be with someone else, maybe? Or, I don't know, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're just sitting there, like, stuck on stupid, kind of, like, really? Like, I mean, you're just not gonna talk to me anymore, you know? And it was just such, a sad feeling. Like, I just want to hug you guys. If Aries, if you're going through this, I really do feel sad. And Aries, if it's maybe, like, you know, someone, an ex or someone that you stopped talking to, they're missing you. You know, they're missing you, okay? So let's see what we have here for the overall energy. So, yeah, Aries, I feel like you're starting to realize that something here may really be over, that this person really doesn't want to be a part of your life anymore. All tied up. Yeah, you're kind of in your feelings about it, Aries. Or they are. You know, whoever this... If you stop talking to somebody, Aries, then, you know, it's this person. They're all in their feelings. Sixth chakra. So with intuition, yeah, see, you know, I feel like you were making excuses about this for a little while, and now your intuition is really kicking in, like, no, dude, like, they're really not calling you. Like, you know what I'm saying? See, we have walking away under the deck. Someone here has really left the building. Someone has really left the building. So, guys, we're going to read you on this side, your person on this side. It can 100% be vice versa. Feel free to flip it, twist it, reverse it. That's fine. Take what resonates. Leave the rest. They're general readings. You guys know this, okay? So here we have on your side, Aries, we have deception. Someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship, and heart-to-heart conversations. Honestly, discuss your feelings with one another. So now, Aries, what's happening here is I feel that you may feel that, you know, you must have been very close to this person. So this could be someone that you were dating. It could be a friend, whatever the case may be. But this is someone that you were very close to, someone that you trusted and opened up to. And now you're starting to realize that, wow, maybe they didn't really like me as much as I like them. Or, you know, maybe we weren't as close as I thought we were, you know? So let's see what we have going on here. Five of Cups. Yeah. Four of Pentacles. Two of Wands. The Devil, Capricorn energy. And the Three of Wands. Oh, Aries. Okay. So with the Five of Cups and the Four of Pentacles with deception here, you're starting to realize with this Five of Cups, you know, you're really missing this person. You know, you're missing them. You're not looking at the friendship or the love here anymore. You're looking at the cups that have spilled. You know, Monday goes by, Tuesday goes by, Thursday. There's 3 days already. You haven't heard from this person. 3 weeks already now. 3 months already now, you know. And, you know, it's just like, wow, really? Nothing at all? Not even a hello? What's up? You know, we were so close. What happened? And with this Four of Pentacles, I feel like you're still holding on. You know, you still have a little bit of hope here. Or you wanted to hold this connection, you know, you wanted to hold on to it, but apparently this person did not feel the same way, okay? Or Aries, you know, this could be you, that you moved away from somebody, and now we have heart-to-heart conversations. We've got the Two of Wands here, the Devil, and the Three of Wands. So what I'm seeing is there's definite distance here. And with that Three of Wands, that's someone that is yearning for communication, yearning to hear from the other person. And with that Devil there, I'm feeling either anger, jealousy, resentment, or just obsession. Like, why aren't they calling? Why aren't they calling? What is going on? Are they with someone else? Or did they find a new friend? Did they find a new girl? Did they find a new guy? What is happening? You know, because there's just no communication coming in. So here we have deserving and dark thoughts. Yeah, see, you thought that this connection, how can I put it, that you had more of a place in this person's life. Like, you deserved more than to just, like, this person moved or just, you know, created distance between you and them and then just didn't talk to you again. Like, you thought that you meant more to this person than that. And with dark thoughts, that's where this Devil is coming in. You know, wow, did they leave me for another friend or another guy, another girl? What is going on? You know, like, they must have found somebody else if they just cut me off like this. Is that the case? Like, it's just like a sheer case of being ghosted, you know? And it hurts. That's just the bottom line. Being ghosted freaking sucks, bro. Like, you know, it does. That's just the way it goes. So I just want to hug you guys if you're the ones going through this. So let's see here. Spirit, tell me about this Five of Cups, please, Spirit. The Hierophant in the reverse. So this is obviously a connection that has ended. This is somebody doing something in a very non-traditional way. So with the Five of Cups and the Hierophant in the reverse, this is you, someone here ending a relationship or a connection or a friendship in a really, like, not nice way. You know, in a very untraditional, unnecessarily not positive type of way. You understand? In a way that would hurt somebody. Yeah, see, we have the Eight of Cups under the deck. Someone here was very unemotional with the way they just cut ties with you. Why is the Four of Pentacles here, please, Spirit? The King of Pentacles. Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy. So the King of Pentacles is generally a representation of a commitment, of a grounded energy, of someone who's stable. So I get a very strong feeling that, like, this is someone that was just in your day-to-day life, like, every day. You understand? Now, this could actually be an earth sign that you're dealing with. It could be. But I'm getting more the energy of the card. Like, this is someone who, it was stable. Like, every day you texted this person, every day you met them after work, or every day after school, or every morning there was a hello, you know, phone, good morning text message on your phone. And now they're just, like, disappeared. Tower. What just happened? Like, it's a very sudden change. Why is the Two of Wands here, please? The King of Swords. So with the Two of Wands represents a decision. And for me, it's also a card about distance. So someone is actually making a decision here to keep their distance. And with that King of Swords, they're serious. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's like this person's unemotional and protecting themselves. And they just really, they're not talking. You know, they're not speaking. Why is the Devil here, please, Spirit? The Fool in the reverse. So you see, there's anger here. There's jealousy here because, you know, Aries, you don't want this person to leave you. You don't want them to go run off. You know what I'm saying? You don't want them to go start over with someone new. And I feel like you're very defensive about this. Like, if someone asks you about this person, like, hey, where's Tommy or where's Julie or whatever? Well, I don't, who cares about Julie? You know what I'm saying? Like, you may get very upset about it when you hear this person's name, I'm feeling, because you're just so hurt by the fact that they just walked away and, like, just forgot about you. What is that, you know? Why is the Three of Wands here, please, Spirit? The Empress. Someone here moved on to start a new beginning somewhere else, and you're just like, what the fudgesicle, dude? You know, you may have had a very good friend that maybe had to move away, let's say, and they just totally forgot you existed because they're not your neighbor anymore. Or it could be, someone that you were dating and things were going really, really great, and then they just fell off the face of the earth. You know, what is that? All right, so let's see here. Now, on your person side, we have love yourself first. Your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. And we have wedding. This situation involves marriage. Interesting. So it could be that we were dealing with someone who was married and they just dipped off and went back to their, you know, person. But let's remember that wedding is also a soul tie. It's a contract. It's a contract. So this person could be working on themselves right now, just focusing on, you know, being selfish and doing them. So we have the King of Wands, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries energy with the Queen of Wands. So that's a soul tie. King and Queen of Wands. That is a marriage right there. That's a husband, a wife. That's two solid people together here. We've got the King of Pentacles. Wow, we've got a lot of people here. King of Pentacles again, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy, the Queen of Swords, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius energy, and the King of Swords. What is this? Aries, what have you gotten yourself into? There's a King and Queen of Swords. I'm in all my years of tarot, I don't think I've ever seen this. There's a King and Queen of Wands and a King and Queen of Swords. Two soul ties. Maybe, Aries, you're married and you were dealing with someone else who was married too. Could that be for some of you? Does that ring a bell? That's possible. Okay. Maybe not for everybody, obviously, but maybe you're married, they were married, and, you know, maybe someone had a little something going on here and, you know, somebody just ghosted. That's insane. That's two separate couples there. Ooh. Or another thing I'm getting here, the King of Wands and the Queen of Wands is a very passionate couple. And the Queen of Swords and the King of Swords is more of like, They're more of like a protective couple. You know who I think about when I see the King and the Queen of Swords? I think about that movie, Mr. and Mrs. Smith with Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie. Like, you know, they kick ass together. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of how I see the King and Queen of Swords, okay? But at the same time, so what I'm getting is hot and cold here. I'm getting that this was a very stable, committed relationship with the King of Pentacles. Because we've got, you know, this energy here. And this is a relationship that went from being very passionate, hot, and for those of you where it was a friendship, it was just very ongoing. Like, you guys were very excited to see each other every single day. And you guys went from that to, like, with the Queen of Swords, just nothing, you know? So let's see what we have here for the clarification for this. Spirit, why is the King of Wands here, please? So the King of Wands is being clarified by the Queen of Cups in reverse and the Star. So someone here is straight up wanting to show that they don't care. Like, it's being done on purpose. Why is the Queen of Wands here, please, Spirit? The Devil. The Devil. I feel like this person, they're literally deliberately not communicating because they specifically want to show, I don't care about you. And with the Queen of Wands here and the Devil, I'm feeling like this person, to be honest with you, may cheat a lot, may have a sexual addiction. The Queen of Wands is someone very sexy, very secure of themselves. Leo, Sagittarius, Aries energy, very sexy, very secure of themselves. And this person, you know, may be very angry, very jealous. Maybe something was done here that sparked, you know, something in them. And they are really wanting to straight up show, I don't give a fuck about you. Like, that's their attitude. Why is this King of Pentacles here, please, Spirit? Four of Wands in the reverse. This is, like I said, the King of Pentacles is very stable. So this is someone that you were speaking to almost every day. It could be a family member. It could be someone that you were once engaged to, once someone that you were living with. And it's, you know, with that in the reverse, it's with the Four of Wands in the reverse, it's a relationship that has died down. Why is the Queen of Swords here, please, Spirit? Four of Pentacles. Yes, someone here is holding back. Someone here is holding back. Why is the King of Swords here, please, Spirit? Ace of Cups. Give me one more on this Ace of Cups, please. The Moon and the Page of Swords. Piscean, Cancerian energy. They moved on. There may be a new love in the picture, a new friend in the picture. So if, let's say this is a friend or something, like whatever it is, this person is making it clear to you, or Aries, you are making it clear to this person, I don't want to communicate with you. I have a new friend. I have a new boyfriend. I have a new girlfriend. I went back to my spouse. Like, this person is doing whatever is best for them. With wedding, it's a contract. So their contract is not with other people. It's with themselves. They put themselves before anything. So if you did something slightly annoying to them, they just cut you off and went off with someone else. Like, you understand what I'm saying? Like, they're deliberately trying to deliberately not talk, like, pass right by you and not look at you. And you know what I'm saying? It's a very harsh energy. Present power and deception. Look at this. We've got three in one. One, two, three, and one, two, three, and with deception here. This, I'm getting very strongly that this could be two marriages. This could be two separate, this could be two people that are married to other people, okay? And they're having an affair and one person just ghosted, okay? Very strongly, okay? There's three things here. We've got the King of Wands, the Queen of Wands, the King of... I'm getting very strongly that for... Even if this resonates only with one person, judgment under the deck, someone here may have reconciled with their person and left the other married person out in the cold. Okay? That may resonate with one person, but that is very strongly what I'm seeing here. For others of you, what I'm seeing here is we have deception here twice. Aries, someone here was not honest with their feelings for you or their intentions. You may have thought that this was a good friend of yours or that this person's had somewhat of a heart or whatever, but they don't. This person, they're showing their power and who they really are. Like, they're showing their true colors right now on how cold they can be. Okay? On how cold they can be. Now, the challenge here is the Ace of Wands. So someone here may have moved away, or the challenge here is that we're waiting for a new beginning in communication. What's crossing the situation with the Wheel of Fortune? No luck. There's no luck in receiving any communication from this person. Again, this person may have actually physically moved, because with the Two of Wands and the Three of Wands, this person may have actually moved location, and because they don't like live close to you anymore or live with you anymore, they just forgot you existed. That's messed up. So we have the Queen of Cups and the Six of Pentacles. So Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy. With that Six of Pentacles, they left you out in the cold to go give to someone else. Or, and this is emotionally, guys, okay? Because the Queen of Cups is very emotional. So Aries, either you left someone out in the cold to possibly go towards a water sign, okay, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy, or you left someone out in the cold to give your heart to somebody else. Or Aries, it could be vice versa. Somebody left you out in the cold to go towards a water sign, or somebody left you out in the cold to go give their heart and their emotions to somebody else. And look at this. We've got the King of Pentacles and the Queen of Pentacles here. We've got three straight couples on the board here. That is crazy. But anyways, three couples here. The King of Wands, the Queen of Wands, the King of Swords, the Queen of Swords, the Queen of Pentacles, the King of Pentacles. Three couples here. So what I'm seeing is one marriage, two marriages, and then one from each of these marriage had their own relationship here. You see that? That's crazy, right? So that may resonate with only one or two people, but what I'm seeing is, somebody's definitely being left out in the cold here. And no wonder why wedding came out. I mean, this is like, yeah, this is going to resonate for somebody, but that's crazy. It's like there was two marriages and each of those people came together and had their own little relationship. And that, see, we have the Four of Wands in the reverse. That didn't come together. So I'm feeling this Aquarius, Gemini, Libra energy here. This person may have reconciled with their person, and because we have the Ace of Cups here, and this other person here, which is Aries energy, the King of Wands, the Queen of Wands, this person, what they want is being left out in the cold, like their emotions are being pushed away. And with that Devil, you have the Devil here too. This is jealousy, obsession, anger about the fact that you've lost this person. Just saying. Wow, guys, this is a heavy one. All right. Leave a message in the description box below. I would love to hear about how this resonates with you guys. Don't forget to like. Don't forget to subscribe to enter a chance to win. And if you want to book me for a personal reading, my information is in the description box below. Take care, loves. Bye.